before I drew my breath. Wow, thine own lips
of your life. Right, yeah, right.
You take all the happy moments of your life and roll them all up. Eternal life is a million times and more.
All right.
Better than that. What I'm trying to tell you is that this life should make us want to have eternal life. I wish I could talk to you. If you ever been so happy that you couldn't contain yourself, this life ought to make us want eternal life. Do I have a witness here? Amen. God bless your hearts. Amen. We are thankful to the Lord for all He do for us.
Amen. Amen.
Because believe me when I tell you, there's some things He's doing for us now.
Come on.
That we are not even aware of.
Right.
Amen. I heard somebody once said that if the Lord take His hands off of us for just one second, calamity would happen all around us. But aren't you glad to report that there are some good days? Can I talk to somebody here? There may have been some heels to climb. There may have been some weary days. But there are some good days. Do I have a witness yet? And it is because of the good days. Can I testify? It's because of the good days. I said, can I testify? It's because of the good days. I said, thank you, Lord. I want the blame. Don't get me started. It's Father's Day. Don't give me style. It's Father's Day. I've had some good days. And I've had some heels to climb. Y'all don't mind if I say a little bit. I've had some weary days. Some lonely nights. When I look around and when I think things over, can I testify all of my good days? They outweigh my bad days, so I won't complain. Sometimes my clouds hang low. I can hardly see the road. I asked a question, Lord. Why am I so much pain? But He knows me. Although my weary eyes, they cannot. So I'll just say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I won't complain. That's enough. trouble. Sometimes songs just start running together in my mind.
Right.
I heard Al Green said, for the good times.
Yeah.
Lay your head upon my pillow. I'm sorry. Happy Father's Day to all of you. We thank the Lord for our choir. Please give them a hand. To the worship service and coming together, blending their melodious voices together in harmony to lift up our spirits and prepare our hearts for the worship service. We thank the Lord for each of you who have come to share in this worship service, because without you, this worship service would not be what it is. And so we thank the Lord for you. Turn to the person sitting next to you and tell them God loves you. And I do too. Amen. This is Father's Day. I wanted to address the thematic theme of the day, which is fathers. But I said on Youth Day we should talk to the parents about their children, and then on Father's and Mother's Day we should talk to the children about their parents. Amen. So we're going to try to stay in line with that, if that's all right with you. So, if you don't mind, everyone who's living in the household of their parents, would you do me a favor and come to the front pew and be my very special guest on this Father's Day. Amen. Thank you so much. Amen. Thank you so much. Now, I know some of you grown folks still living with your parents, too. Amen. You need to come on up. It ain't no shame to be grown and living with your parents.
Amen.
You know, Abraham lived with his father.
All right.
And he was fully grown. As a matter of fact, Abraham was married and still living in his father's house. Are y'all listening to me? I know sometimes y'all see kids walking and y'all get locked in. I want you to hear what I'm saying.
Amen.
Abraham had got married and everything was fully grown and was still living in his father's house.
All right.
Anybody remember that besides me? Just only five of y'all. And God told Abraham, I want you to get up. Leave your father's house. Go to a land that I will show thee. So ain't nothing wrong with being grown living in your parents' house.
All right.
So you grown folks don't need to be bashful, because I know who you are. The church know who you are. Your Facebook friends know who you are. Amen. What's done in the dark will be brought to the light.
Tell it.
What's in the light shines brightest the light. Amen. I need to talk to you on this Father's Day.
All right.
Amen. And I ain't got all day to wait for you to make up your mind.
All right.
Bless your heart. Amen. Now, you know, some of my children heard me this morning because they was here. So let's see how well they remember this. If you live in my house, who rule you follow?
Yours.
Thank you. My house, my rules, right? Thank you very much. See, they know. Some of y'all don't get it. You live in my house, you follow my rules. I pay the bills.
All right.
You can help pay the bills. That still don't give you no voice in my house.
Right.
Y'all hear me?
Yeah.
One of the things we've done too much of in this society is pamper our adult children.
All right.
We let them have their girlfriends over to spend the night in our house. We let them have their boyfriends over to spend the night in our house.
All right.
Ain't happening in my house. Remember one time my son, one of my adult sons, brought his girlfriend over. He thought because it was 12 o'clock that he's going to be able to sneak her in. I sat up till she left. You don't get to sleep in my house
all right.
without my permission.
All right.
And children, put your earmuffs on. Y'all remember earmuffs from the movie? Y'all remember earmuffs? Earmuffs. Y'all got to do the earmuffs. Because I got to tell the adults something.